It's Sunday, the 5th of February, 2017. Welcome along to today's United Kingdom Talk. It's many, many birthdays today, including mine. It is my birthday today. Oh, thank you so much for your millions, boys and girls. Millions. You know, Facebook went into overload this morning. Millions and millions of lovely, lovely little messages from you, boys and girls. Thank you so much. I do appreciate all of those. A couple of you have mentioned you can't write on my wall. Yes, I turned that off some time ago because you get all sorts of rubbish coming through there. You can't like turn off like individual messages or individual people. It's either all or nothing. So I turned that off. And what happens if you try and write on my wall? It goes into some sort of little box and I get a message come up saying there's a message waiting for you to approve, and then I check it and then I click approve and then it appears. I'm not exactly sure 100% how that works. I think some people still manage to get past that anyway. I'm not quite sure how they do it. Secret people, clearly helped by Mr. Putrid in Russia. Yes, at this very moment he's trying to hack into this programme and take over, boys and girls. Shocking. Shocking. There are, of course, lots of other birthdays as well. And don't worry, my darlings, they'll be coming up at the end of the day's show. And I particularly remember my birthdays with Mum and Dad. And we'd always, they would always, for me and my sister, for my sister and I, they would try and make it as special as possible. And certainly through my very younger years, they were fantastic. Always a lovely cake. I think Dad used to go somewhere around Fleet Street and went to this place that made proper cakes. Now, the cakes you get in supermarkets now, they're okay. You know, they're all right. But they're nothing like the cakes that my dad used to get from somewhere where, because he used to work on the Evening Standard, you see, in Fleet Street. And he'd order this cake and he'd bring it home. And, you know, you'd be sitting there watching the telly and suddenly the lights would go out and Dad would bring in the birthday cake. And I think it was Dad carrying it, actually. And Mum would be there as well. And they'd come in singing Happy Birthday. It was all right. Until, of course, you're a teenager. And then it gets very, very embarrassing, doesn't it? Yeah, it does. Let me tell you, at right now, I absolutely hate surprise parties. I went away for my 50th birthday. To see Barry Manilow, who happened to be on my birthday in New York. But that really, the main reason was so that no one could throw a surprise birthday party. Honestly, it just doesn't do it for me at all. Isn't it funny? And yet that's what I've done all for years and years. I've done birthday parties and things like that. So thank you very much for your birthdays and what have you. I've got a couple of gifts to open this morning. First of all, I must open this very, very large one. From Ray Reynolds and Johnny Key, regulars at the karaoke. Now, it says Dell on the box. And can you imagine? It's very light, though. This must be the lightest computer that they've ever made. It really would. And can you just imagine the disappointment in my little head that would be if it wasn't a Dell computer? I really can't. I've got to open this today because I've no idea what it is. And I'm one of those people. I absolutely refuse to open anything to do with birthdays or Christmas before the birthday or the Christmas day. I really don't go along with that business. And I mention this to you every Christmas now. You know, you're waiting for me to open this, aren't you? I'll wait a bit longer. Oh, by the way, Joey, you still haven't sent me your address yet, dear. Oh, God, you don't know how these things... Joey wants me to send him something, and he hasn't sent me his address. How can I send it? Am I supposed to, you know, look, sort of go for the universe and try and locate you there somewhere, dear? God's sake. Right, let's open this. yeah, I say this every Christmas. You know, people that... Shall I open it a little bit more? That people that open Christmas presents, or they give Christmas presents before Christmas Day. I mean, what's all that about? And then Christmas Day comes. Oh, and I got that yesterday. And then, oh, I've got nothing to open today. So don't do it. You're spoiling it for everyone. Don't give presents before the day. Or if you do, make sure they're wrapped up and a little note on there. Not to be opened before the day. So let me just open my brand new Dell computer. Oh, there's a lot of newspapers in it. Look. Is it like newspaper? Oh, these are very handy for Katie the cat. Because she goes toilet on the floor now. She don't use a litter tray anymore. Oh, it's like an Amazon parcel. Look, There's something tiny inside. Is it, did you get this from Amazon, Ray and Johnny? Oh, no, do you know, it looks like a gun. Is it a gun? Have we become a, is there anything else? Or was it nothing else in there? You haven't hidden cash down the bottom at all, have you? Hang on, there's something at the bottom there. Oh, there's something at the bottom. Hang on. No, no, there isn't. Oh. Oh. No cash, boys. Where's the cash? Where's the cash? I've got the Building Society ringing me up every day. People are waiting to borrow money from me, dear. Come on, let's have a look at this. To Chris, happy birthday from Ray and Johnny. Look how that's nicely all wrapped up like that. What do you think? That looks like a ukulele, doesn't it? Hope it's not a ukulele. I won't be able to play one of those. I haven't got the nails. Do you need long nails to play ukuleles? Like a guitar? What could this be? I've no idea. It says Ashton on the side. How exciting. I think this must be my biggest birthday present this year. Ooh. Ooh. What is it? Buh, buh, buh. It is a ukulele in matching colour bag. Oh, my God. Well, how do you play these then, dear? Oh, shall I attempt to play it on this programme now? I think we need to attempt to play this morning. Ashton, it's an Ashton ukulele. I don't know if it's as good as your one, though, Ray. Your one's looking very spick and span now, isn't it? He spends ages polishing his one. Right, hang on a minute. I can't get the damn thing open now. One moment, please. Oh, there we are. Is it? Oh, there we are. That's it. Just a minute. Why can't I get this thing open? Oh, it comes in a little plastic bag. How lovely. Ah, look. It's in the colours of the United Kingdom Talk logo. Yeah. Oh, which way up should it be? That one's at the bottom. I can never remember. Does it? Let's What do you want me to play? Oh, yeah. Who do you think you are, kidding, mister? It plays notes. And oh, hang on. Do you think you are kidding, Mr. Hitler? Oh, I don't. If you think we're on the run, ba 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 ba. Oh, thank you. Thank you for this wonderful ukulele. I must display this up here somewhere like that. Trouble is, you put something like this up here and they actually think you can play it. And it's in its little carry bag as well. Where's that gone? So that it doesn't get wet. Thank you to Ray Reynolds and Johnny Key. Trying to get me to play the ukulele. Yes, thank you, boys. There's another bag here that Ray Reynolds gave me. I must open this as well. Oh, this has got a card in it. Now, Wendy actually tried to send me something to the old postal address that we have, and it didn't get to me, unfortunately. Please don't, if you know the old postal address, don't use it anymore. Because the stuff doesn't get to me anymore. All right, my darlings, let's have a look at this card here. This is from, I think it's going to be from Ray. Oh, it's a 3D card. A 3D card, look at this. Happy birthday, Chris. Lots of love from Ray Rhodes. Can you see that's 3D? Oh, you can, can't you? See, look at the candles sort of glowing away there. And Ray likes to work. He's got many different biros, right? And as you can see, every letter is a different colour because he's got this thing in his head that if he uses each biro a little bit, then they all last a lot longer. Very good idea, Ray. Very good. Thank you, Ray. Let me put that down there in that bag. And what's in this box? No, I don't know what this is, Ray. This is very heavy. You haven't wrapped up a brick, eh? Donald Trump needs some bricks. He's building a wall. Did you know that? I'm going to build a wall. We'll build it, dear, and stop talking about it. Christ's sake, man. What's wrong with him? I do hope these people that just talk and don't do anything. Now, let's have a look. Ooh. Oh, it's Morecambe and Wise. In colour. The BBC. Is this all of them? My God, is this all? Oh, I love Morecambe and Wise. One minute. Bring me sunshine. Bring. It is. Good God. Morecambe and Wise are the greatest comedy double act ever to grace our TV screens. which is true. The fabulous mixture of sketches, musical numbers, BBC collection, 9 series, 5 Christmas specials, and every memorable moment of Eric and Ernie's BBC career, including the legendary Singing in the Rain and the Breakfast Stripper one. That is the sketch that sticks in my mind more than anything else. Look it up on YouTube. Not before you finish watching this, please, if you don't mind. Look it up on YouTube. The Morecambe and Wise Kitchen. Try to type in that, and you should. And it plays the stripper music, and they do it all in time. Things in the kitchen to stripping. Thank you, Ray. This is a fantastic present. Look at all the DVDs in here, dear. Look at them all. And there's 2 lots. Oh, gosh. I shall never have nothing to watch on the telly again, will I? Thank you very, very much, Ray Reynolds and Johnny Key for my ukulele. Really, really appreciate that. It's very, very nice of you, darling. And Maureen, she bought me in a lovely blue orchid, which is actually downstairs. I've got to bring it up here and put that up there. So thank you very, very much. I really, really appreciate those gifts. Good. Let's do some news this morning, boys and girls. Now, more important than my birthday is this item of news. Are you ready? Are you a lover of chocolate? You are, aren't you? Mars bars, maybe? A little bit of Milky Way. I think people on diet seem to think they can have a Milky Way and that's okay. But it's still chocolate, isn't it? They fool themselves. Or those, what are those round things? Maltesers. The lighter snack. Yeah, if you have one of them, yes. But if you have the old box, they're just as bad as blooming Mars bar, aren't they? Well, bad news, boys and girls. They're at it again. Chocolate manufacturers are said to be reducing their products by 20%. In line with government plans to combat child obesity. It doesn't work, you just buy 2, don't ya? I do the same with crisps. The crisps got smaller and smaller, so now you buy 2 bags. Doesn't work, all this shrinking stuff. Oh, I have a bit of trouble with my stomach last night. It feels like it's blown right up. Do you know what I mean? It feels like it's rising up. My stomach. I'm sure I'm full of air or something, or it's a muscle problem or something like that. You know, I push it, there's no pain or anything. Whenever I go down to the doctors, I'm going to keep going down there. And he has a poke around like that. And he says, well, just carry on with the powder you're drinking. Oh, I don't know. I've got a scan in a few weeks though. I've got a scan just down here on the right-hand side. And I'm seeing a stomach specialist at the Royal Free in London. I think that's at the end of March. Hang on a minute. Let me just check on my diary. I have to write everything down that I made a bit of a boo-boo. 6th of March. So it's in about a month. Oh, hang on a minute. So that's on the 27th and that's on the 6th. Oh, they're within a week of each other. So that's good. So that'll be maybe they'll find something and be able to help me with this ridiculous problem that's been going on and on now for ages now. But yes, I've got to write everything down. I made a boo-boo yesterday. I booked someone to fill in for me on the 18th of February somewhere. But that's not my date. You know, there's already someone there on that date and it should have been the 11th. So I've got the dates mixed up. And fortunately, Ben Parker was down this other place last night with Wayne and mentioned that I'd got a fill-in. The 18th. And I thought, well, it can't be the 18th. And I've given someone the wrong date. So a bit of a boo-boo there. Well, I am losing my mind. And as I am a year older today, I think I can accept that. I think you need to accept that. So sorry about that. We're trying to sort that one out. I didn't book anything on the 11th, so I can still do that. But, you know, it's one of those things. Anyway, back to this. Mars, Nestle and Mondelez. Who's Mondelez? Oh, they own Cadbury, do they? Oh, they're the company that have ruined Cadbury's chocolate, which I loved since I was a tight, since I can remember Cadbury's chocolate. This company bought it, Mondelez, which owns Cadbury, and they'd done something to it. They completely ruined Cadbury's chocolate. Fortunately, we still have Galaxy, which is all right. Anyway, these companies could make their products smaller in a bid to stop them being highlighted. In a new report by Public Health England, according to the Sunday Times, several companies are reportedly reformulating their high sugar products with artificial sweeteners. But that, I mean, that's just as bad, isn't it? Artificial sweeteners to appease the government. But chocolate makers are said to be concerned that changing the ingredients will alter the taste of the bars. Well, I think they've already done that to Cadbury's. It tastes. They say that the ingredients are exactly the same, but it tastes different to me now. I mean, it really does. Certainly, those cream eggs are a little bit smaller. Oh, I do like a cream egg. Oh, I had two yesterday. See, now they've got smaller. So what do? You go and buy two. This making things smaller is actually making people eat more, I think. You know, because two slightly smaller ones are much bigger than one large one. I think you're going to find it goes the other way. People are going to get even fatter. You know, I don't know how some people can sit on those plane seats. I mean, I could, there's no way I would fit comfortably now, I don't think, in an economy seat. And there are people that are a little bit larger than me, lovies. You know, one I know. Who actually runs a bar, and he is enormous, and it's all fat. He's not big, it's all fat. And he's recently been away in an economy seat on a plane. Oh my God. I mean, not only would it be very uncomfortable for him, but what about the people sitting next to you, dear? You know, you try and put your arm on there and you end up resting on someone's fat. It would be mine if I was sitting on there, but I'm not doing any flying at the moment. It gets on my nerves, flying, does my head in. So very bad news for us chocolate lovers there. Where will it all end? That's the thing. Now, here's something to make you feel really sick today. Now, you might be sick for one or the other. I personally feel sick knowing this story on both of them. It's a bit of a rude story. We don't usually do rude stories on this programme. Here we go. Katie Price, i.e. Jordan, you know, nothing normal about her, is it? It's all fake. Fake eyelashes, fake breasts, fake. Everything is fake. Katie Price has admitted she spent a night with, are you ready for this, Simon Cowell. I don't know which one makes me feel sicker. I mean, why would you write this thing in the paper anyway? Because they want attention, that's why. There is no talent there, you see. There is no talent. It's just about attention and getting the old breasts out for everyone to see. That's what it is. The TV star, 38. TV star? All right, celebrity. Star? No, dear. You're not a star, love. You're not a TV star. Angela Rippon is a TV star. Gloria Hunniford is a TV star. You're just a Z-list celebrity, my love. God's sake. The TV celebrity, 38, this is in the Sun this morning, 38. Come on, love. Come on. She says she's 38, said the X Factor Supremo invited her back to his London mansion after an awards. Well, there can't have been anyone else around then, dear. He must have been desperate that night. Katie, who was single at the time, it makes a change, love, revealed, we kissed, I undressed and we got into bed. We had fun. Oh, God. Oh. Fancy making me sick on my birthday, Simon and Katie. You are awful. I bet you had the old camera running as well, didn't you? Oh, dear. The loose women. I'm not saying anything about that. Isn't that funny how she is just on loose women? Loose women. The Loose Women panellist, which is the most awful. Have you seen that? Oh, four or five old bags sit there cackling away for half an hour or an hour, whatever. It is just horrendous, that. Awful. The Loose Women panellist, you'd be better off to rerun Tom and Jerry's than watching the crap that's on there in the afternoon. The Loose Women panellist confessed to an intimate night of passion with Simon Cowell and told how she loved the hairy chest. Oh, but just, I mean, it just makes you feel really violently sick, doesn't it? Feeling violently sick on that one. So just awful, just awful. Now, on the subject of breasts, listen to this. Still loving it. Again, this is in the sun this morning. We're doing a lot of sun stories this morning. There's something strange and a bit rude about the McDonald's logo, which I bet you've never noticed, have you? Think about that big old yellow M with the red background. As well as signifying the M for McDonald's, the iconic golden arches represents something far stranger. Strange and mysterious on a psychological level. Any idea? Any idea what that could be? Think of it, that big old M like that, you know, the big M. Believe it or not, the rounded logo was actually designed to represent a pair of breasts. I mean, it's typically American, isn't it? We don't have anything like that in this country. You know, when you see Harrods, that H doesn't signify anything, does it? Fortnum & Mason's F&M doesn't signify anything. John Lewis, JL, doesn't signify anything at all. It's just John Lewis. McDonald's, two great big pair of old breasts staring you in the face. God knows what they make the milkshakes out of in there now. Oh, God. It's making me feel sick again. The Freudian symbol was devised in the fast food giant's earliest days, but McDonald's was ready to abandon the logo in the 1960s. That's when design consultant and psychologist Louis Cheskin stepped in to urge company bosses to keep the booby design. The symbolism behind the arches was intended to represent a mother's nurturing breasts, subconsciously making hungry customers feel comforted and at home. You're having a laugh, and have you sat in those plastic chairs at McDonald's? Oh, you get about 10 minutes and then your ass is going to sleep and it like that. I always take a cushion in. Well, I don't go in there anymore. But I used to take a cushion in. Years ago, I did have McDonald's. I can't lie to you. I am vegetarian now, but I used to enjoy a Big Mac. Although you never want to smell it. You know, don't ever take that top bit of bread off. Or that, no, they call it a bun, don't they? They call it a bun. Don't take that top bit of bun off and smell it. Not a good idea, darling. You just eat that as quickly as possible, and I guarantee in half an hour you'll want another one. They do not fill a hole, do they? They really don't. So there you are. Next time you go in McDonald's, just imagine that, boys and girls. You are sitting there. You are sitting there sucking on a breast. That is what they intended you to think. It really is. So yesterday, we didn't do a show yesterday. I popped down to my uncle. My uncle died recently. We had the funeral on Wednesday, and they did ashes scattering at the local rugby club where he was a member for many, many years. And actually, I got there a little bit too late. It was the Vandals Rugby Club in Weybridge in Surrey. And I got stuck in Weybridge coming through there. A lot of traffic and what have you going through there on a Saturday afternoon. But it was nice. And as I got there, my cousin Helen was sprinkling ashes. And there was my cousin Tim and, of course, her mum, Marion, which was Terry's auntie. I saw these ashes. You know, it always worries me when people are sprinkling ashes. You know, you've only got to have a gust of wind blowing in the wrong direction. And you know, it's not very nice to eat your own family, is it? It really isn't. So if you are ever going to any ashes scattering or anything like that, take one of those masks with you. You know, like they wear in, is it Japan or China, where they're all walking around with masks on all the time. You've seen it in the videos when they have news clips from like airports or something like that. They're all walking around with these little white masks on. I mean, God knows the air must be bad there if you've got to do that, but highly advisable. You know, if you're going to an ashes scattering, wear one of those masks because you really don't want to breathe that stuff in, my love. All right? Good old Uncle Terry. He would have liked that one. Rest in peace, Uncle Terry. Let's do some other birthdays today, boys and girls. It's birthday time. Happy birthday. These people share their birthdays with me today. Aren't you lucky? Yes. Owen Tate, happy birthday to Owen. Heather Chandler, happy birthday, Heather. Mark Anthony Hobbs is 39 years old today. Happy birthday, Mark. Happy birthday to Daniel Aiscoff, 31 today. Happy birthday to Aubrey Dobson, to Marygrace Andoy Cabrera, 41 years old today. Oh, 40s is the one wonderful period of time. My favourite ages were between 32 and 47. That was my favourite period of life, 32 to 47. And Jools Kinska Craig is 46 years old tonight. Let's sing the happy birthday song, including to me today, including to me. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. Have a wonderful day, boys and girls, if it's your birthday. Funnily enough, last night I was DJing at what has become my main place of employment, Central Station in Wharfdale Road, King's Cross, and it was there 25th birthday last night. So lots of birthdays happening all at the same time. And I was really worried that someone had spotted that it was going to be my birthday today. Because, of course, I was still there at midnight as time clicked over into my birthday. I thought, oh, please don't anyone know. And fortunately, no one did. So we didn't have suddenly a cake presented on stage because I can't deal with that. There's a very special person that watches this show who will remain nameless. But the lady knows that I can't deal with it. And there was a little bit of a thing a while ago for a birthday. And I haven't forgiven myself for that yet. But I can't deal with surprises like that. I really can't. Isn't that funny? You can't deal with that. But there you go. That's one of those things. It's a little bit like, I suppose, like the builder, you know, going to a builder's house. And generally, it's a bit of a dump. You know, really good builders who build wonderful houses for people, but they can't do it for themselves. And that's strange how we a little bit like that, eh? But never mind. Let me see if there's any messages from... was it Friday, the last show we did? Because we didn't do one yesterday. I was down the old... Oh, come on. Damn mice won't work now. Come on, scroll down. It won't work. Why won't the mouse work? Perhaps I'll get myself a mouse for Christmas. There we are. That's going down there. Is that working? No. Oh, come on. There we are. Just about got that. Shania says, you must come to the Isle of Wight. I'm hoping to come to the Isle of Wight sometime this year, Shania. Do not worry, my love. All right? I hope to come to the Isle of Wight this year. Then you can show me around the radio station that you all work on. Ray Reynolds says, pardon me, boy, is that the cha-cha-cha-cha-choo-choo track 29? Man, can you give me a shine? I don't know what he's going. He's on another planet, Ray Reynolds. He really is. We were singing that cha-cha-choo-choo thing. And Joanna also says, it's Chattanooga-choo-choo. We were singing about that, weren't we? Yes. That's it today. Thank you very much, boys and girls. And again, thank you for your millions of birthday messages coming in. As I say, you can't put them on my wall. And if you do try, somehow, I don't understand how it works. It doesn't seem to work for everyone. But sometimes it'll drop into a box which says there's a message for you to approve. I'll see it and approve it. Unless it's someone trying to sell. They try and sell. I get a lot of Ray-Bans. People try and sell Ray-Bans and things like that on my wall, and rude stuff or political stuff. I do try and keep that generally off my wall. My wall is for humorous things and stuff like that generally, and my work stuff, all right? Now, tonight, it's Sunday, the 5th of February, 2017, and I'll be hosting a open mic karaoke night tonight. We do it once a month now. That's at the Golden Lion in Sydenham. Starts at 9 o'clock and finishes at 12 midnight. If you want to come and sing a song or bring an instrument or something to plug in like that, it's open mic and karaoke tonight at the Golden Lion in Sydenham from 9 o'clock until 12 midnight. Apart from that, thank you very much for watching and listening, and I'll see you on the next show.